I don't think we have time for another one. It'll be very extraordinary.
What was all that nonsense about? I thought we just adjourned and that was it. I was tidying my desk off.
Did you get through the right lobby? We voted against now.
There was no shortage of guidance. Into the breech, out of the muzzle, guaranteed painless.
Another pint, please.
Ah, it's the Liberals playing silly buggers, end of term and all that. They forced a division.
Hey.
What quiet word has the Home Secretary got for the Liberal Chief Whip?
Shh. Shall I get him in then?
Oh. We've got to get up, Bill. We've got the journal meeting tonight about the conference. Will you be there?
No, I've promised to get back to leaving.
Enjoy yourself. See you in September at Blackpool,
Aye.
Right.
Tom. So you get no cooperation.
I was sorry to hear about your wife.
Thanks, Bill. I think she's better off.
I don't suppose there's that I can do. You'll let me know if there is, eh?
Good of you to offer, lad. I'm sorry you can't make the meeting tonight. On my way, Reg. There's no point in joining if you're not going to join. Think about it.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine. I thought I'd let you have the books back before you went off. Thanks.
How'd you find them?
They help pass the time. Pamphlet was a bit heavy.
Yeah. We didn't know when to expect you, otherwise...
Oh, that's all right.
Tom thought it might be another week.
No.
Did you get the flowers?
Thanks.
I'd have come to see you, but Tom said you didn't want visitors. It's nothing serious, is it, Winnie?
No, nothing like that. So, what's been happening this week?
Not a lot.
What about last unemployment bill?
Disappeared Wednesday. It appears our beloved leader is having second thought. It's being reworked for next session. Ha, 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 ha. I shan't be sorry to be shot of it for a couple of months. Jim McNabb keeps telling me it's the first 15 years of the worst. Hey. Hey.
Oh, shit. It's ridiculous. I'm sorry. It just happens.
Hey, what is it, Winnie?
I've... Fine, Bill. I've been in hospital and now I'm out.
So what are those, tears of joy?
I've told you, it just happens. It's a nervous reaction.
Reaction to what, Winnie?
To the termination of a very slight, rather inconvenient pregnancy. All right?
Ah. That's my taxi. I'll send him away and phone for another.
No, you won't get one. Go on, get off. Enjoy recess. I'll see you at conference.
Look, if you give me the number, I'll phone your husband. He should drive up.
Richard thinks I've just been in for a check-up. It has nothing to do with him. Taxi.
No.
I don't have to ask you to...
Oh, no, of course not. Now, you take good care, eh?
I'm really glad you were here. I felt bloody frightful. See you in Blackpool.
Be around, comrade. Go well.
Happy birthday to you, dear Jane. Happy birthday to you.
Trying to give it up.
It's a nice party. Jane seems fine. The house is in recess, so I'll be available if there's anything you want me to do.
Like what?
I don't know. Look after the children, maybe, or whatever.
No, I have an arrangement with my mother. It's this summer she retires.
Fixed a holiday?
I've booked the cottage in Mulligan.
Huh. What, a fortnight?
Mm-hmm.
When?
August. First 2 weeks. Pour one for Mother, will you? I'll take it through.
I'm doing a summer school at Ruskin. Last 2 weeks. I'd like to take them with me, if that's okay.
I'll have to think about it. I'll ask Mother. She may have made other arrangements.
Ah, you might try consulting the children while you're about it. They are people, too, with rights and preferences.
I can manage quite well, thank you, without your advice on the handling of the children.
Handling? What are you talking about? Handling? What do you think they are? Some sort of putty? Jesus. God.
Look, I don't want to argue, all right? I'll let you know.
Jesus Christ. You're shriveling. Do you know that? You're wrinkling up into nothing, into a little sack, into a little bag of pus. There's no joy left in you. There's no warmth, no largeness, no generosity. For Christ's sake, see yourself, Miriam. It's not pleasant. And while you're about it, you can tell your mother those children aren't about to lose a father, divorce or no divorce, okay?
Jeffrey Raines wants Michael for his part.
I think Michael ought to go to bed. Come and see.
Is that tea, Dad?
Mm-hmm. There you go. Hey. Still got old Rabbit, eh? He's almost as old as you are.
He's 9 and a half. Mummy told me. You bought him in Alden Market one Saturday afternoon and I was in the carry cart.
Yeah. Hi. Hello. What time is it? Oh, fine. I was coming in anyway. I've been busy. That's right. Okay. Anything special? Fine. Oh, 10? Fine.
Hey, don't settle. Who was it?
Jowett.
At 8:30?
So?
Maybe it's too early. Think about it a bit.
What is this, Alf? My start of at 10? So, the General Secretary of the party wants a pre-conference session on organisation with his agents.
Red alert.
How's that?
It's happened 3 times before in the 20-some years I've spent in the job, and each time it's turned out to be a standby operation for a snap election.
God almighty.
Keep calling. Need all the help we can get. Not certain, of course. After the 1970 fiasco, Arthur will be in no hurry.
You've had nothing to take it.
No, you wouldn't. You'll hear when you need to, not before. We had a caucus meeting Thursday. The general view is our leader's keen to improve his majority in the House so he can shake off his image as a prisoner of the left.
That's very nearly funny, Al.
Very nearly.
So what's the feeling? Will he risk it or what?
It's doubtful. Not as things stand. But if he can lose a couple of 100,000 unemployed and cook up a few decent trade figures this summer, he might just give it a whirl in November. Might.
Okay. Let's have the bad news.
Did you have plans for the summer?
Yes. Last 2 weeks in August, Ruskin Summer School, otherwise I'm here.
Well, that should be all right. Do you have your diary, Andy?
Yes. I have my diary, Alf, but I'll fill it,
okay? Bill. If you're not going to listen, you may as well leave right now. Either you take it from me, or you take it from the GMC Thursday. You please yourself.
Take what, Alf? Orders?
Tell you what. If you like them, we'll call them suggestions. If you don't, they'll just have to be orders.
Okay, let's go.
Twenty-seventh this month, afternoon.
Free.
Lely Sporting Club are running a beauty contest at the swimming bath. They want you to judge it. 28th evening.
Free.
Masonic Lodge Banquet, guest of honour. 30th evening.
Free.
Junior Chamber of Commerce, Young Executive of the Year Award. 5th of August. What's wrong? We're going too fast for you.
Not too fast, Alf, just too far. Alf, beauty contests degrade. Masons are petty bourgeois buffoons. The only thing I would consent to give to the Lely Young Executive of the Year is an illuminated scroll containing the names of all those he's declared redundant over the past 12 months. What is this shit, Alf?
I'll tell you what this shit is. It's your bread and butter, iron rations for the duration. And I don't give a monkey's tosser what your personal views on masons and beauty contests are. Because the object of the exercise is not to set you at ease with your sodding conscience, but to get you a platform and win a few votes if there's an election this autumn. As far as I'm concerned, the honeymoon's over, and I've got work to do.
5th of August, even.
Say it all, Alf.
Look, you've had a free hand. We've gone all the way with you. You can't say we haven't. Voting against the government. Ocean's a century here. The occupation of Bryant's. The communist tag. The smears. Your private life. The lot. All the way.
If there are any objections to my politics...
There aren't! It's your social image there are objections to.
I am the same man that won last
Shite,
April.
Shite, same man. You're being sued for divorce, man. You're living with a young girl in Wordsworth Avenue. You're going around procuring abortions for constituents.
What?
Don't what me, comrade. I've spent the last week keeping it out of the recorder. I've had the Society for the Protection of the Unborn Child round. I've had 3 parish priests. I've had that Burke from Radio Manchester on the phone every day, so don't come the what with me, right?
As far as I'm concerned, it hasn't happened. Even if it did?
Especially if it did. There were 23,000 Catholics in Lely at last count, and most of them vote Labour. Especially if it did.
There was nothing illegal...
I'm glad to hear it. You get my drift?
Yeah, I get the drift, Alf.
August the 5th evening.
That's Trades Council.
Scrap it. Shaw's throwing a fundraising cheese and wine do in Southward. Be there,
okay?
Junction with Mecca, bubum, who else? Proudly presents Miss Lely 1976. Before I call on these very important and very delectable young ladies down there, it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to Mr. William Brand, MP, the chairman of the panel you see before you. Mr. William Brand.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted to be here today to help officiate at this function. Let me introduce you now to my fellow judges. On my left, Miss Angela Bellway. I now take pleasure in declaring the St. Aloysius Women's Sodality Fete open. Enjoy yourself.
Spain, thou art dead. I'll away and get the rest in. Now, Bill, how's the glass, all right?
It's fine, Bill.
I'm glad you could come.
Well, you missed it for worlds.
Thanks. Got the summer ahead of you, eh? Nice one.
Oh, yes.
£70 this little lot's made. One of these every week, the party would be in clover. All right, loved one, I'll see to it.
You got taller.
It's just the way I hold myself.
Thought it was the lifts.
Changed my life.
Can you dance in them?
I can manage a passable Frankenstein shuffle.
Great movie.
Terrific.
Well?
Excuse me, is this where they're going to have the revolution?
Hey, old comrades!
Oh, it's all right, little people, it's up! How goes it,
comrade? Oh, grand. Makes all the difference knowing you're on this
trip. And I'm very far from being alone, William, as you can no doubt see for yourself. Go in, food, drink!
God, it's up here!
Right, come in.
Later, perhaps.
I think I'm off.
Oh, I suddenly took it in the head to come here. I completely forgotten.
Anyway.
I'll have to stay on a bit.
Yeah.
Well,
say goodbye.
Nice talking to you.
Yes, it was fun.
Not off already, are we?
Afraid so. Hard day tomorrow. Is Angie back?
Kitchen, okay.
I'm away. Thanks for the
coffee, sir.
I should go.
2 minutes. How's Miriam?
She's all right.
She's divorcing you, isn't she?
Is she?
Sugar?
One.
Bernard told me about it weeks ago. You take things so gravely.
It's in hand. I'm enrolled for a course in flippancy, 4 days a week, Westminster.
Already?
No, not really.
You didn't think it would be easy, did you?
No, I just thought it would be possible.
Shan't disturb you. I'm just establishing a little order. Oh, that IS crowd's pushing glass around. They might kick them. They're in the far corner. Well, back to the fray. Oh, there's a fellow from the recorder here says he'd like a word with you before you leave. Okay? Well, on you go then with your concepts here.
At least half of him would really like you to screw me, you know. Save him having you himself. And what is truly pathetic is that if he heard me say that, he wouldn't know what I was talking about. Do you?
Yes, I think so. I just can't quite figure out how I got in there.
Mr. Brandt. Peter Malone, recorder.
How do you do?
I'm sorry to bother you in the middle of a party.
It's no bother. What's the problem?
Actually,
I have to be somewhere else rather soon.
It won't take a minute, promise. I'll tell you what it is. I just wondered if we could fix the time sometime in the week when we could do an interview. See,
I've been given free run of the Futures pages, and I'd like to put some life into them. And, what better way of starting than with a feature on you?
What sort of feature did you have in mind?
Up to you. It would be good to have a piece on the problems people bring you and how you deal with them. You know, housing problems, rents, marriage, abortion, whatever terms you want. I'm a great admirer.
Look, I've got 2 minutes, Mr. Malone. Now, why don't you say what it is you really want? Hmm?
I'm sorry, I'm not quite with
you. Quite. But you do have my meaning, so.
Look, I've told you quite clearly what I'd like to do. Now, if you're not interested in being interviewed, we won't press you. We lose a good article, you lose the publicity. Besides, there's more than one way to skin a cat.
Don't try telling a cat that. Look, in 4 months, your greasy rag, you call a paper, hasn't had a single good word to say about me, not a syllable. You've smeared and sneered at everything I've said and done. It was your office that sold that picture of me at Branch to Fleet Street. Don't deny it, because I have the proof, right? At the same time, you've printed nothing that might indicate, however vaguely, that I was doing anything at all that might serve the interests of the people of Lee. So what's all this about, eh? Suddenly, you want to do an in-depth, sympathetic profile. Pull the other one, Malone. It plays a passable version of who do you think you're kidding Mr. Hitler in 6-8 time. I'll tell you something else. You go for me, you start scratching, you better make it stick. Because if you don't, you and your miserable employers are about to discover ways of skinning a cat you never even dreamt of.
Tried to call, but couldn't get through.
Uh-huh.
We went on to the YS thing at the Adelphi. Okay.
Sure.
Look. If it's about my being at Shaw's party last night, I've said I'm sorry once already. And that was probably once too often. I have an existence too. I have a right to exist. And I'm not prepared to go on being only where you're not when you're up here. Hmm?
It's fine.
Oh, for God's sake. Don't go into that man of stone routine. Talk.
Okay. I think I'm going to have to find a new place. Here, I mean. I need a separate, I need an independent base. I don't think I can do the job well enough from here, and I think it would be better for both of us.
Fine. Shall I help you to look? There's always something going down at the advice centre.
No, thanks. I'll manage.
Okay. Have you sorted out the Ruskin thing yet? Do I come or what?
Well, it looks as though I'm going to be allowed to take the kids, and I owe them time, so...
Yeah. I might spend a few days with my mother. Did Joe Fitton get in touch?
No. What about?
I told you he's doing a pamphlet on medical attitudes to abortion in the area. He's keen to put something in about Marples and the Mrs. Pilling case. I said he should call you.
No, he didn't call.
Maybe he rang when the phone was off the hook. You could give him a ring at the advice centre. He's anxious to see you before you go off to Oxford.
I'm doing something at Radio Manchester today, in any case. I don't know how I can help him.
How do you mean?
I've been advised to keep a low profile on the abortion issue.
What does that mean?
It means not airing my views and practice in right-wing weeklies or left-wing occasional pamphlets.
Advised by whom?
By the party here.
Why? I thought they were with you.
There's an autumn election scare brewing. The Lili Party want a Labour member. Principals have therefore to be suspended for the duration. I'm promised full use of them again when the matter's been resolved, one way or the other. In the meantime, I behave.
Do you want toast?
No, thanks.
Is that why you're moving house?
If you want to be a hero, well, just follow me.
Working class hero John Lennon. The second choice of our studio guest this beautiful Monday morning, Mr. Bill Brand, Labour MP for Lili. And remember, if you want to talk to our guest or ask him questions, the number to ring is 061, if you're outside Manchester, 137 4433. And we have another call now. This is Monday Choice.
And let's hope you get your mortgage in time for the baby.
Thanks for calling. Monday Choice. Mrs. McDermott, I think.
Mrs. McDermott, that's right.
Could you turn your radio down, Mrs. McDermott? We can hear it in the background there. Lovely, thank you. You have a question, I believe?
Yes. I'd like to ask Mr. Brand his views on the abortion question. As a member of the Society for the Protection of the Unborn Child, I feel that last year's bill, amending the law on abortion, didn't go far enough, and I'd like to see the law strengthened so as to eliminate the thousands of unnecessary abortions we still see permitted every year in this country. Could I ask Mr. Brand whether he agrees with me that the abortion laws are still far too permissive?
Thank you, Mrs. McDermott. The whole abortion issue is, of course, a highly complex one.
I know that there are many women who, for religious or other reasons, can't accept the idea of abortion in any shape or form. What I say to them is, they have the right to reject the termination of pregnancy in their own case, but by what right do they seek to harass those many more women who have different principles?
Are you saying, Mr. Brand, that it is a woman's right to kill her unborn children? Is that what you're saying? Would you help a perfectly healthy...
I'm not sure I accept your somewhat emotive terminology, Mrs. McDermott. In what sense can we talk of children being unborn?
We must butt in here now because we're coming up to news time very soon. You're listening to Radio Manchester, 10:30 and news time.
I've been cut off.
Ring again.
What's happening, Mike? Okay. Clever, isn't it? We've lost her. Sorry about that. Bit fishy, eh? Food prices to fetuses. I'm right in thinking you don't want to go on with that.
Whatever you say. I fancy a bit of music myself.
Oxford, what do you think?
Brilliant.
Great. I like all the scaffolding down the churches.
Oh, get in!
Ow, that knew it.
Hey, cool it.
I'll show you the crash later. It's really quite professional.
Terrific.
Right then, this is yours. And that's the revised schedule. There is a third seminar now on women in literature, which Bonnie will take, but you might like to be involved.
Fine.
Yes, good. You'll see we've had to change the title yet again. It's now called Women and Politics. How glam can you get? There's 32 enrolled, slightly more women than men, but no more than is usual at these things. And you'll see we've given over the last day to reporting back in a general free-for-all. You can stay for that, can you? Mm. Oh, good, good. Yes, well, I think that's everything. Do you know Oxford at all?
No, not really.
It's really lovely this time of year, with the students gone. Bonnie Clark and Chris Waite arrived this evening, and John Venables later in the week, probably Friday. Do you know the Home Secretary?
No, of him.
He used to be a fellow of All Souls. And I thought you might have encountered him.
No, I don't read Encounter. I never got the habit. Mm.
Well, you'll hear the gong for dinner. Enjoy yourself.
Not that way, silly. Three squares. Anyway, women can drive trains. They do it in China. I've seen them.
But there's one thing women can't do, what men can do.
What?
Not telling you.
Come on, come and get it. Stop, Jane. Come. Jane! Give us the ball! Give us the ball back! <All right.
laughs> What I'm carefully not saying, you'll have noticed, is that the political left is, in terms of actual practice, markedly different from the political right in this respect. Free women, women who exist in their own right as persons before women, are pretty difficult to find any place in political parties as elsewhere. Of course, the left can lay claim to a different tradition, philosophically speaking, from the right. In very crude terms, it's the difference between comrades and ladies, if you like. But beneath the ideologies, remarkable correspondences cluster. Now, I looked this out before I came down here. Some of you may have read it. It's Clara Zetkin's Reminiscences of Lenin. Here's Lenin on sexuality. You must be aware of the famous theory that in communist society the satisfaction of sexual desires, of love, will be as simple and unimportant as drinking a glass of water. I think this glass of water theory is completely un-Marxist. Of course, thirst must be satisfied, but will the normal man, in normal circumstances, lie down in the gutter and drink out of a puddle or out of a glass with a rim greasy from many lips? Now, we can pick up the main strands in the argument of that passage after dinner. But for the moment, I'd like you to consider that final sentence, because, you see, when it comes down to it, for Lenin, as for any other patriarch, communist or capitalist, things ultimately turn around what is good for the normal man.
Hmm? What was that book again?
It's...
Excuse me, Bill. I have a telephone appointment.
Can it wait?
They say not. No, it's your constituency.
I'll see you all at lunch. Help yourself to the books.
There you are, just there.
Ah, thank you.
Bill Brand?
Hello, Anne. Which Sunday paper? No,
Oh, I wouldn't know. I don't read it. No one's been in touch. Oh, Christ. So, how did they... Oh, never mind. It doesn't matter. It's probably that weevil from the recorder put them onto it like last time. What? Look, I can't give details over the phone. Alf. Alf, all right, Alf. The gynecologist said no. I asked around. The ring held. I fixed her up at a private clinic. Never mind where the money came from. The bill was paid. An unwanted pregnancy was terminated. No law was broken. I don't care what it looks like to the vermin who make the news. That's what happened. Well, too bad. So fire me. All right. I'll see you when I get back. Oh, by the way, Alf. I think I found a house. Uh-huh. We try to please, Alf. Right.
That's what's his name.
Oh, yes.
Friend of yours.
We vote in the same lobby, usually.
Labour leaders. Historian, wasn't he?
Of sorts. All soul sorts.
Would it be too much to ask if he was ever licorice soul sorts? Sorry, I couldn't resist it.
Have a good journey.
Yes, it was splendid, thank you.
Good. Well, I must say, it's marvellous of you to spare us the time. Well, come along now, let me introduce you to everyone. This is Bonnie Clark, who teaches literature here.
How do you do?
And Chris Waite, who writes novels.
How do you do?
Will Brand. This is John Venables, whom I'm sure you all recognise.
We never met, have we? How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good, isn't this wonderful? I don't wish I could spend a whole week with you. I used to be here, you know, at Oxford. All souls. Sometimes I wish I'd never left.
Well, come along and have a drink. I'm sure you're
ready. No, I do think that lady there has touched on something very central, very important. Namely, in a democracy such as ours, isn't it vital that every opinion, every voice should be heard? I'll answer this way, and I hope you won't find it too casuistically political. You say important voices are missing in our colloquium. Tories, liberals, nationalists, and so on. Well, yes and no. Yes, for the obvious reasons you've indicated. No, this is where I might become, shall we say, controversial. No, because at this particular moment in our political life, it's perfectly possible to argue that the present Labour Party, both in the House and in the country, includes and subsumes every kind of opinion and value within that spectrum that you've just described. Because the Labour Party is, in a sense, always has been, a consortium, an alliance of necessary and fruitful contradictions expressive of the whole of a society, not just of a segment or a class. And as I say, this has always been so, ever since the party formed, out of its diverse beginnings at the turn of the last century. But what makes it crucially representative today, as I see it, is that those historic differences between hand and brain, between wealth and labour, between position and equality, are sensed and expressed within our party at a higher intensity than anywhere else. Certainly within any of the other historic political parties. The Labour Party has, in a sense, taken the main ground. The real debate, as I now see it, can only come there. And as long as we comport ourselves as responsible, mature, balanced people, then we can continue to hold that main vital ground that is the road to the future.
Yes.
The one historic difference John Venables fails to mention is, of course, that between men and women. And in my own seminar, and in my own seminars, as in the others, we've seen that the domination of the one by the other is as characteristic of parties of the left, including my own party, as of parties of the right.
Oh, come, Brad, you can't mean that. What about our sex discrimination?
Mistitled, in my view. We'd have been better calling it what it plainly is, a less inequality for women act. I don't argue it's unimportant. Far from it. But historically, it was the party responding to forces outside itself, to a largely autonomous movement of women who were no longer content to lie back and think of England. On the political spectrum issue, I think that the minister, John Venables, has a point. If anyone doubts the width and the scope of action and belief within the Labour Party, I have here a few words from The Future of Socialism, which some of you may have read. I am sure that a definite limit exists to the degree of equality which is desirable. We do not want equality of incomes, since extra responsibility and exceptional talent require and deserve a differential reward. I do not myself want to see all private education disappear. Nor the PM denied an official car, nor the Queen riding a bicycle, nor the manufacture of Rolls Royces banned, nor the Brigade of Guards, nor Oxford and Cambridge, nor Boodles, nor the Royal Yacht Squadron, nor anything so dull and colourless as this. Not Ian MacLeod, not Keith Joseph, not Edward Boyle, Tony Crossland. The Future of Socialism.
Daddy?
Soon be home, son.
Said I should get a house of my own. I got one.
I give up. You're just not bloody corrigible, are you? Come on, let's get that Sunday people thing sorted out.